Joining us now is Glenn Ponis from the Aircraft Owners and Pilots Association. I appreciate your time tonight. I'd like to begin where Brian left off with the pilot shortage. He said the furloughed pilots need to go through a certain training to get back in the air. What is that process? How long does it take?
That's a really good question, Marty, and thank you for having me. The pilot training program, a lot of that is going to come down to they will need to spend time in simulators going through a whole series of refreshers. So they will be refreshing their standard procedures. They'll also be refreshing their emergency procedures, because those are some of the most important things that they can't practice while they're in an airplane. So they will be spending a lot of time doing that. There's a lot of check boxes that have to be marked off. And so that's where we're going to see that sort of closing of the pipeline a little bit.
Are there other factors in addition to the pandemic and these furloughs that may be playing into a pilot shortage?
I think what we're seeing in part, and what we've been reading in the research, is that we're starting to see early retirements and those kinds of things. There were pressures brought on by COVID, and people were sitting there saying, it may be time for me to leave now. So that's one of the big things, is that we're seeing that when people have left or they've cleared out so that other people could maintain jobs, since if they were near the end of their career, that's sort of exacerbating the process. So those people aren't even eligible. They're not coming back into the job.
I understand you've been in the industry for 30 years. Have you ever seen anything that compares to what we're seeing right now?
I really have not. And, we talk with colleagues. I have a number of colleagues who are airline transport pilots, and we have not seen anything like this. And it's going to get worse before it gets better. I mean, you know, when you look at the Boeing Aviation Career Outlook, they said 659,000 jobs in the United States alone over the next 20 years are going to be needed. And that's after COVID. So we're talking about a huge long-term pathway that we're going to need to fill a lot of jobs coming up in the future.
The other edge of the sword is recruiting. Are people wanting to become pilots? Is there incentive to make sure that they take the profession of aviation seriously and jump in?
Well, you know, that's also a great question, because when you and I were young, we were able to get airplane rides. We were able to go to airports. Nowadays, since 9/11, airports are closed. No one is allowed in. It seems to be this sort of closed environment. So who gets to actually experience aviation the way perhaps you and I did, or people of our generation? They really don't. So as a result, we have large segments of our population of young men and women who've never had the chance to experience that. And it's even worse in underrepresented communities, urban, rural communities, where they don't even see people who look like them who are pilots. So it's really hard to try to think about a career in aviation when you have no experience with it.
So what's being done to recruit people to get out into these communities that are underserved, underrepresented?
Well, there's a lot of stuff happening nationwide, and I can speak on behalf of Aircraft Owners and Pilots Association. The AOPA Foundation has a four-year curriculum that we provide free of charge, curriculum, professional development, ongoing support to high schools across the United States. It's designed to prepare students for two pathways, to become a pilot or to become a drone pilot. And the whole notion is to prepare students not just to become pilots, but to present them all the possible opportunities that we see in aviation and open their eyes to that, and also to make them career ready so that when they leave high school, they have everything in place that they need to become successful, whether it's going on to additional education or going directly into the job market.
Last question for you. You love to fly. You love to be in the skies. What's your pitch for somebody who may be considering a job in aviation, because we need them?
We really do. And my pitch is very simple. The first time you take the controls of an airplane, there's a sense of freedom. We have a student from Steubenville High School. If you get a chance to see the video, it's amazing. And she describes it as freedom. And I can't say it any better than Lexi could. And so I would say to people, get out there, try to get these kinds of programs into your schools. Make sure students are aware of programs that are aviation cadet programs to get them involved in aviation. Because there is really nothing like it. Once you leave the ground, you never see the world the same.
We'll leave it there. Glenn Ponis, Aircraft Owners and Pilots Association representative, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks so much, Maureen.